so famous, so popular, so strong? Because we opened the gate for the different disciplines, and they are popular and very famous because not too much muscles. So we know how to judge the muscles. We know how to judge the definition. It seems to be easy for all of us, but it's difficult to assess properly the size of the musculature. In some categories, we face this problem, which is the men's physique, body fitness, bikini. So we have to be very careful with these categories, and we have to be very careful with bodybuilding. Nowadays, bodybuilding goes in the wrong direction. So all together, only we together can change this direction to bring bodybuilding again on the floor. The most difficult decisions are to classify athletes in men's physique if they are bodybuilders, just to have a clear idea about. We create the muscular men's physique, which is still category not for bodybuilders. In our meaning, bodybuilders, I mean. So this is a category for muscular men's physique, but still for the men's physique. The easiest way is to follow your proposals for the top five and to correct the proposals if necessary, because that will be, let's say, an advice where we wish to go. So don't be stick with your proposals. Just follow what's going on the stage. If you will notice that some people that you propose for the top five suddenly are not placed in the first fallout, you have to ask yourself twice why it's happened. If this is a mistake from the head judge or is something behind, then you will, maybe you will notice. If not, you still have a right to ask the head judge why the number that I propose is not placed in the first fallout. Because we are the partners in the judges' panel. So we cooperate for the best result. All the body disadvantages destroy our sport, like gynecomasty, extended bellies, and any kind of injections. We're not gonna tell the athletes that we consider he has some or she has some injections. We just have to understand the anatomy, and we understand the muscles. If the muscles look strange, not natural, not aesthetic, this is the reason to place athlete down. But if we wish to deliver a kind of message, it's not enough to place one or two places down, because this is not a clear message. The athlete will consider, okay, I'm two places down because maybe somebody's better. But we wish to tell him, no, no, it's because you do the wrong things. So to deliver this kind of message, to save the future, we have to place the mask. Only this kind of message works. So this is a tough decision because we love this sport. That's only the reason why it's so tough. So that's why before you start to assess them, before you start to realize they are nice or less nice, first remove the ones that have the body disadvantages, place them last. It will allow you to make the decision easier. As soon as you start to assess them and you will notice, oh, he's a nice competitor, but a little bit extended belly, you will start to cheat yourself. Thinking, oh, maybe he eats a little bit too much, because you will love the body. So you will try to protect the athlete because you love the sport. So the first step before you assess them, just make a decision. Extended belly, so you don't care anymore. Is nice athlete or not? He has extended belly or kind of injections, he must be placed last. Very important to be brave for this decision, because we are working for the nice future. That because we are open for every kind of people training in the gyms. So that's why we have such number of competitors. If we will start to destroy what we did already, like place bodybuilders high in the men's physique, we will destroy the men's physique category. So it's very, very important to be careful. Watch the call-outs. I still don't saw the list of competitors, but following the last competition, which was very successful regarding timing, if we're going to have more than 15 athletes in the category, we're going to do the elimination, but we will not ask you for the top 15, for the 15 process. We're going to ask you for the 10 process. If there will be 15 athletes, we will straight place them. So that means that in some categories, we're going to have place from 1 to 15, from another category is 1 to 10 or 1 to 12. This is to save the time. And in the case of the elimination and the tie, if tie appear, so we will not solve the tie because this is another tie. So in this case, if we will have 12, we will let 12 compete after elimination out. So we are looking for the top 10. But if appear 12 or 13, we will let compete 13. This is the way to speed up the competition. So we consider, after the decision of the Congress, we're going to make the final decision, but we consider the most important 10 place for the athletes. But if we have placed 15, we're going to place 15, 14, 14. You're going to be informed anyway, every elimination round, what to do. We're going to let you know 10 crosses or 15 crosses, because I'm still not sure what is the situation with the number of competitors. It's going to be run through competition. So we start in the morning, looks tough, because this is the, so far, 9 countries. So that means that you're going to work from the morning to the evening. But maybe you have more than one judge from the country, which is so far the case of just 2 countries.
Sorry, Pavel, yes. That's an important question. Of course, the judges will have tomorrow drinks and small snacks on the table, but as well, the judges will receive a voucher to have lunch. When you left the place, on the right side, there is an Italian restaurant. You show the voucher and you have a proper meal. The thing that you have to do is to...
Even if necessary to do 10 minutes or 15 minutes break, we're going to do it.
Okay.
Just to have a lunch.
Because it's important. It's a tough work, and we wish to take care of you. So, José María, for tomorrow, it's very important to have the water and the small things.
But even if necessary, we will explain to the competitors, even if necessary, and you have to eat some snack on the table so you can do it.
Sure.
Because this is a long day competition. It will be tomorrow, after tomorrow, the same. So,
we wish to take care of our judges. Okay? It's important.
Okay, any questions?
Before it was 2-3-4 hours. Now, especially in these invitational events, in the European Championship, we had 70 judges, because all the teams are coming with judges.
Yeah, over 70.
In these invitational events, are less judges, so you are going to work harder, and we wish to take care of you.
Any questions?
Olympia Amatér. Už sme po registrácii a po vážení a veľa mňa stojí nikto iný ako sám prezident IFBB, Rafael Sandocha. Hello, Mr. President.
Hello, very pleased to welcome the ISLAP team in Marbella. Such a nice resort for tourists and now such amazing place for a great competition as it is the Olympia Amatér.
Zdraví vás prezident IFBB. Je veľmi rád, že ISLAPS prišiel do Marbeji, do takého krásneho miesta, ktoré je absolútne vhodné práve na takúto súťaž. Mr. President, how are you satisfied with the spring season?
Fantastic season. IFBB is growing in the 5 continents. Very recently, we just got the fantastic news of our recognition as Olympic sport in America. Next September, we are going to have in Vietnam our participation in the Asian Beach Games. And this is because of the excellent work of our members in the different continents. This spring brought us a new world record in participation in the European Championship in Santa Susana. And very new events like the Olympia that is growing, the Olympia Amatér is a driving force, the Arnold Sport Festival in Africa for the very first time, and the Ben Wader Legacy Cup with the name of our founder, the IFBB Diamond Cup. Many events and many opportunities to find new talents in our sport and to enjoy the passion for bodybuilding and fitness.
Prezident Sandocha je maximálne spokojný s jarnou sezónou. Keď sa pozrieme pár rokov dozadu, tak v IFBB zďaleka nebolo toľko súťaží ako je dnes. Je to Arnold Classic, je to Olympia, Diamond Cup. Čakajú nás azijské olympijské hry, kde poprvýkrát bodybuilding a fitness bude považovaný za olympijský šport. Mr. President, how about Elite World Cup? We are awaiting it. Can you explain everybody what it is?
Well, this is another project from the IFBB. We are here to serve the sport. And we discovered that the new categories brought thousands of new talents. Athletes that dream to become champions, but as well athletes that are in the elite. That is why we brought the name. And the concept is to bring new competitions for athletes that become champions and wish to remain in the amateur level. It's going to be something very attractive, and it's going to be played together with our international amateur events, not as a separate event.
Keďže tých pretekárov je už strašne veľa, naozaj tisíce pretekárov, ktoré súťažia v rámci tých amatérskych súťaží, IFBB by sa rozhodlo vytvoriť elitnú kategóriu pre tých najlepších, ktorí ešte nechcú prejsť do pro kategórie, a to bude práve Elite World Cup. Who can compete in Elite World Cup?
The champions and the top three in the continental events from the previous 2 years are going to be automatically entitled as elite athletes. Then they will be able to compete. They will compete in the elite event in the evening at the best moment of all our major international amateur events, and then they will get awards, prize money, and as well points to participate in a great final that is going to be held in Barcelona next spring 2017. In Barcelona, the Olympic city and the Olympic facilities, and it's going to be by itself a very strong moment for the growth of our sport.
Takže súťažiť môžu všetci šampióni zo všetkých súťaží IFBB medzinárodných, predpokladám. Takisto top 3 z majstrovstiev Európy aj z majstrovstiev sveta. Na týchto súťažiach sa budú vyhrávať finančné odmeny, plus sa budú zbierať body. Pretekári, ktorí budú mať dostatočný počet bodov, sa môžu zúčastniť finals, teda tej poslednej hlavnej veľkej súťaže, kde sa bude bojovať o titul Miss Universe, ak si správne pamätám. A víťaz samozrejme dostane ďalšiu nejakú väčšiu finančnú odmenu. Where are going to be these competitions? Which cities? Which states?
We are going to put the competition together with our World Men Championship in Benidorm, some of the top Olympias, the South American Continental Championship for the South American athletes, the Olympia in Hong Kong. We are going to have a total of 6 events before the end of the year. And then the great final for the 2016 season at the beginning of 2017 in Barcelona.
Súťaže okrem toho, že budú v Hongkongu, v Južnej Amerike, budú po celom svete. Posledná finálna súťaž bude v Barcelone a nebude to v roku 2016, ale bude to zhruba po nejakých 5 až 6 súťažiach, ktoré sa budú konať na jeseň až na jar. Teda posledná súťaž, tá hlavná, bude v Barcelone 2017.
We've heard something about the fit model category, but we haven't seen much yet. So can you tell us something about that?
So many things. Well, our duty, if you look back a few years ago, we had just bodybuilding, male and female. Then the IFBB is growing. Why? Because the new generations are looking for new ways to show their physical talent. That brought bikini and men's physique. And now, is the time for fit models. Why not? Healthy boys and girls that like to look great through proper healthy habits, lifestyle habits, proper nutrition, good exercise, fit model. Yes, we are in the 21st century. This is the century of the revolution of fitness, and we are proud of the beauty of our sport and the beauty of our athletes. That is why it's burning fit model.
Takže kedysi dávno, neviem, či si to ešte pamätáte, možno niektorí z vás áno, existoval len mužský a ženský bodybuilding. Potom samozrejme verejnosť si začala vyžadovať také jemnejšie osvalenie. Prišiel body fitness, potom prišli bikiny a fyzik. No a dnes vzniká kategória fit model, ktorá bude ešte o takých menších svaloch. To, čo povedal pán prezident, v podstate oni chcú, aby sa táto kategória
páčila ľuďom, aby sa na to pozerali, aby to bolo o zdravom životnom štýle. Chcú podporovať tento šport, pretože ho majú radi, milujú ho, tak vytvorili práve aj takúto novú kategóriu, aby ste sa vysúťažili.
What do you think, where is the first official international competition going to be? When and where?
For Elite.
For Fit Model.
For Fit Model. Well, we already had a few tests. The first international test was held in Poland. We are conducting some tests in United Kingdom, and we still have not decided the first main event, but it's going to be, of course, during this autumn season.
Nejaké súťaže sa už konali, ale uvažuje sa o ďalšej súťaži, medzinárodnej veľkej súťaži, ktorá sa určite bude konať na jeseň, takže ak máte záujem, tak sa snažte, pripravujte sa, možno sa vám podarí nejakým spôsobom sa tam dostať.
There's one question I would like to ask. What is the main feature you look for in a bikini fitness girl?
Fitness girls is a combination of beauty, emotion, and muscles, plenty of flexibility, and plenty of inspiration. I consider that this is the role model for the women in the 21st century. We are looking for a great tool, first for our athletes to enjoy, and then to forward a message to the society. Be fit, train, eat properly, and enjoy life.
Opýtala som sa pána prezidenta Santochu, čo hľadá u bikini fitnessky, akú nejakú črtu, ktorá ho konkrétne zaujíma, tak podľa všetkého je to úplne všetko dokopy, to znamená nielen svalový rozvoj, krása tváre, ale aj to, čo je vo vnútri. A hlavne to asi, čo hľadajú podľa toho, čo povedal, je nielen to, že robíte ten šport, ale aj to, či z neho máte radosť. Pravdepodobne to na tom pódiu vidno.
I've heard that Arnold Classic moved from Madrid to Barcelona and I would like to know why. And how are the preparations for the competition going?
Well, the experience in Madrid had been great. And after 5 years, we consider it's time for a new challenge. Barcelona is an Olympic city, it's a pearl of the Mediterranean, it's a meeting point for sport and for industry. It's a city that truly loves sport and has one of the most modern facilities in the world. And the largest facilities in the world. So we thought this is the right place for the right event. That is why we are proud to announce that yes, we are going to be in Barcelona in September, ready to break new records.
Barcelona je asi viac mesto športu ako Madrid. Je to perla španielska. Jednoducho vidno, že pán prezident má k tomuto mestu veľmi pozitívny vzťah.
Preparations, how is it going?
Very good. We are having a huge venue for the expo. We know that we are going to break the records of participants. And the venue is so modern that imagine, for example, when the people step in, the control is just by the body heat. So it's a very modern facility. All the visitors will have Wi-Fi. Even if there are 25,000 persons at the same time, it's enough Wi-Fi capacity for them. So we are really excited with the possibility of Barcelona. Hotels are nearby, the place, and then the Mediterranean is waiting for the people for the enjoyment as well.
OK, môžete sa veľmi tešiť, pretože aj keď vás tam bude 25 000 v tej hale, tak všetci budete mať Wi-Fi. To je určite pozitívna správa. Takisto bude tam obrovské expo. Pán prezident očakáva, že aj zlomia rekord v počte súťažiacich. Hotely sú veľmi blízko, takže kto chce, nech sa prihlási a má tú možnosť, teda môže sa zúčastniť súťaže Arnold Classic.
OK, Mr. President, thank you very much for the interview and have a nice day.
Spasiba. I hope you enjoy Marbella and the weekend that we have ahead of us. Plenty of passion for sport and enjoyment.